Hey guys, what's up? It's Barry Michael Doyle here, and well, I'm so sorry I have been out of action for so long. For those of you who don't know my channel, I make tutorials on React Native applications, how to build them from scratch to finish, and yeah, it just teaches you the whole development cycle. That's actually all I have to say. Go check out my videos. There's a little link there in the top right there if you want to check it out. And now for a message to my faithful viewers who have probably been wondering where the heck I've been. Well, I'm not dead, fortunately. I hope you guys are happy about that. But I thought I'd better give you guys a little update and just let you know that I'm not dead and that I do plan to keep YouTubing. Things have been, I wouldn't say tough, just things have been exciting in my life. I think I mentioned last year, not last year, last month, that I am working at a company called iPlatform as a front-end developer, building React components and hooking them up to Redux and doing all those cool kind of things. I'm a front-end developer for iPlatform. I don't know, go Google iPlatform. They're pretty cool. Although the product's not done yet, so yeah. And also there's like a hectic windstorm outside. So if you hear some of that's what's happening. Basically, I moved across the country last month, started working. And then I moved out to a flat, but the flat doesn't have internet. I'm busy using mobile data to connect to the internet, so that makes developing native apps while using mobile data, it's quite a mission. It's like really, I've tried a few times, and the thing is, I can't give you guys tutorials if I'm not making apps. So I've had to put the React Native development on hold for a bit. And you know, I have been working full time, so yeah, spending 9 hours a day coding. You kind of want to go see your friends afterwards and not come home and make videos. But I really do want to make videos. I've been so amped to make videos. So yeah, that's who I've been. I do have great plans for the channel, and I have great backup plans for in case my internet doesn't come soon. I've applied for fiber internet at my new flat, but it's taking its time getting here, so that's made making apps difficult. Basically, hey, wait, hang on. Let's distract you with a picture of me. There is a picture of me over there. Ooh, check it out. That's me being lazy and chilling at work. You can see we have like a lovely little coffee machine there. There's my colleague Oswin looking at me sleeping in my chair. I'm not sleeping. I'm actually coding there. As you can see, code's open. And I have a really nice office chair. And I know it makes me look fat while I'm like leaning down like that, but I'm not fat. I'm quite fit actually. You'd be surprised. And yeah. My job is very comfortable, as you can see. I get to sit back and code React stuff all day. And as you guys know, I'm pretty decent at it. Which I must say, working on React stuff 9 hours a day for like a whole month has made me a really good developer. So expect really high quality content when I do come back. Another massive cool announcement. Let me show you this. I got this lovely little thank you letter from Expo. Like Expo sent me this thank you letter, and they sent me a bunch of cool little Expo stickers, which are actually still at my office on my desk there. That's my work laptop chilling there. It was just Expo guys, if you're watching, that was extremely encouraging. It was so lovely to get that letter of like you guys just telling me how great my stuff is. And this was like, you know, within the first week or two of me like making my YouTube videos, they sent this. The only thing is I'm in South Africa, so it took like forever to arrive. So it arrived like 2 weeks ago. And oh, it was just so inspiring. They say I inspire them, but they've really inspired me. Like, oh, it was so kind of them. They also sent me a t-shirt, which is really nice. It's like this V-neck t-shirt, that sort of Expo color, dark blue. And it's got a little Expo logo and text on it in the top left-hand corner of my shirt. Ah, it's lovely. I wear it to work, and my colleagues are like, "Hey, what's Expo?" And I'm like, "Well, go watch my YouTube videos." And then they're like, "Nah." So that doesn't happen. But yes, Expo, you guys are amazing. Anyway, back to my update for December. So I do want to make more apps and then teach you how to make those little apps that I make. And I'm going to keep those a secret as to what they are because I've got like two apps that I'm kind of got in mind. They're both very different from each other. One's kind of fun, and one is kind of like this will teach you a lot of cool things. But I'm not going to be able to do that without my internet. Although, I do plan to make some other stuff. I want to make some sort of React tip videos. I'll start a new playlist on that where I teach you about stuff like styled components, and that's actually all I can think of now. There's stateless functional components versus lifecycle components. I did sort of teach you that in my tutorial series, but to sort of teach you that concept on its own might help you decide when and where to use what techniques for React. So that's kind of something I'm excited to do. I might go back into code fights for a bit, although that didn't seem very popular with you guys. So let me know if you want to see code fights and I'll do some more code fights. But if not, then I'll just leave it. Maybe I can do some of those code fight challenges because I've become a lot better at my JavaScript now, so I could do that. And then another thing that I wanted to do, by the way, this is going completely uncut. I'm just going to post this because if I don't, like, oh, it's going to be chaotic. So I hope you enjoy the freestyle non-editing stuff. I edited my last update, my November update, but the December update, this one is just going to be clear, uncut. I'll cut off the start because I spent like 5 seconds not really editing anything. But yeah, so as I was saying, I wanted to do a React tips kind of series and potentially start up code fights again. Then another thing I wanted to do was the ES6 tips, because like we do a lot of ES6 stuff in React, especially using Redux, because the Redux library kind of adopts a lot of ES6 concepts. So we do use it, but it would be cool if I could teach you ES6 on its own with just JavaScript so that you can kind of understand, again, also like the React tips, like where and when to use ES6 and how you can use it and best practices. And it will just make you a better developer if I can teach it to you that way. And again, I'm able to do that instead of building a whole app. I can do that on like a JS Fiddle or something. So it's not too much of a big deal for me to do while I don't have proper internet access. Right. And then another thing, something I was not familiar with before I started working as a full-time front-end developer doing React. Well, I was doing React.js, so I'm a web developer. I did not ever work with unit tests. And now I'm pretty good at writing unit tests because they're quite fun and relaxing to do. Like when you've had like a long week and you're just like, ah, oh, I'm tired, you go write some unit tests on your Friday afternoons, and it's just the most chilled thing ever. It's amazing. So I'm going to teach you guys how to do some unit tests using Jest. I think I might just take the Capo Keys application. I'll update it to the latest SDK and stuff, and then stick it up on GitHub so you guys can just take the full finished Capo Keys application down from GitHub. And then I will write, well, I'll do a tutorial showing you how you can implement testing. So, and that's testing using the Jest package. So yeah, that's pretty much my update for December. Trust me, there will be more videos coming soon. I'm actually like, as I'm thinking now, I'm sitting here, I'm recording this video. I'm gonna record another video, and then hopefully that will come out later this week because I actually have to edit the other video that comes out and plan it properly. But there will be another video within a week from now available to you guys. I just have to decide which one. Maybe you guys can help me out with sharing in the comments below. Anyway, one final thing. I'm pretty involved with well, yeah, I'm just saving. I'm hodling Bitcoin. So yeah, I'm saving Bitcoin because I'm just quite invested in that. But I also wanted to just mention like ad revenue, it doesn't pay much. Like I'm not making much on YouTube ads. I'm getting ads now, which is amazing. Thank you for watching my videos, because as you watch videos and you get ads and you watch through the whole ads, they actually pay me for it, which is great. So this is actually worthwhile. Although it's not much. And I mean, I was in a truck accident earlier this year. I think I mentioned it in my last update. So I'm busy paying off a new car, and yeah, so I'm living pretty frugally at the moment. So if you guys could help me out financially, that would be amazing. I have mentioned that there's Patreon that I'm signed up there. I have one dude donating me $1 every month. It's amazing. It's just like, thanks, man. I really appreciate that. But yeah, there's a link up there in the right-hand corner of the screen. You can go donate to me via Patreon. And then yeah, with Bitcoin, I'm going to leave my Bitcoin address in the description of my videos in case you guys want to donate that way. That's a nice, easy way to donate. It doesn't matter what currency you're with, because you can just donate however you want there. If you haven't got a exchange to get Bitcoin, then I don't know. I recommend Luna if you're South African. If you're not, Luna kind of works. They're overseas in a few countries. So I'll leave a link to them. It's my little affiliate link. If you spend 500 rand exchanging there, then you'll get 10 rand using that link. So it's not much, but that 10 rand could be worth like 10 grand, like 10,000 rand in like 2 years' time, because Bitcoin is just skyrocketing, which is amazing. But yes, if you're able to donate, that would be amazing. I'd really appreciate that. But otherwise, just keep watching my content because I really enjoy chatting to you guys and teaching you guys things. And I'm sorry, I haven't been teaching you guys things for a while. Oh, one final thing with Bitcoin. I found this cool app called Minergate. I'll leave a link to the in the description below for that as well. Also under my Bitcoin address, it'll be there, Minergate. It works on all operating systems. It works on like Windows, Mac, Linux, and on phones as well, like Android and iOS as well. So you can basically mine like the most profitable cryptocurrencies. It's got the smart miner built into it, so it'll mine what's the most profitable at the time of like logging in. So if you follow my link, I get like a little bonus, which would be really nice. But yeah, I just encourage you to do that. I mean, we're all developers, so you might as well use your machine to mine some cryptocurrency on the side while you're developing, unless it uses up all your resources. I set it up and let it run in the background on like really low resource settings, so it doesn't really make much of a difference to my development. But over time, I make a little bit of profit on the side, so it's a nice way to generate some income there on the side. Anyway, guys, if you have any questions, you can see that I do actually reply to the comments. So, ask your questions away in the comments. Sometimes I'm in a bad mood and I read the comments and I'm just like, blah, type out randomly. But I really do appreciate the comments. Like every now and then I get a YouTube comment and I'm like, YouTube, I need to get back to YouTube. And you guys, the persistent comments have really been the thing that's brought me back. So thank you so much for that. You guys have been very encouraging. I really appreciate it. It's been so much fun to just chat with you guys in the comments and help you out if you guys get stuck, etc. Let me know if there's anything specific you want to like think about first. Here's the list. So either ES6 tips, React specific tips, or code fights. I have a feeling you guys don't want code fights. But if you want code fights, let me know and we'll do code fights. Cool. Anyway, guys, that's all for now. If you do enjoy my videos, please consider donating. You don't have to. Definitely leave a like in the video and leave some comments. I really appreciate them. Anyway, guys, till the next video, keep well, and I promise there'll be a video up by next week. Ciao.